Hey there, what's up? I'm Brett, and today on Math Hacks, we are discussing the difference between combinations and permutations. Combinations and permutations are just one of those topics that's really easy to confuse. And that's because a lot of times in real life, we say combination when we mean permutation. So the difference between the two has to do with ordering. In permutations, the order matters, whereas with combinations, the order doesn't matter. So for example, say I had a combination lock, and the combination to it was 1, 2, 3. Now if it were truly a combination lock, I could walk up to it and put in the numbers 3, 2, 1, and it would open. Or I could enter 2, 1, 3, and it would open. Basically, it would open with any combination of the numbers 1, 2, 3. But as we know, that's not how locks work. They only open when you enter the number in the specific order in which they're supposed to be entered. And that is the definition of a permutation. So the difference between a combination and permutation has everything to do with whether the order matters or not. So we'll be digging deeper into this idea of combinations and permutations in today's lesson. So if you're a little confused by my initial explanation of them, hang in there, because I think by the end of today's lesson, you're going to have a really good grasp for what the difference is. Additionally, we'll be digging into the formulas for each today. So we'll be looking at the choose formula for combinations and the permutate formula for permutations. And I'll be showing you the factorial notation, which is a very common notation found in combinatorics problems. The problem we're going to be looking at today is figuring out how many different 5-card hands can be made from a standard deck of 52 cards. Now, we could jump straight into the combinations and permutations formulas, but instead, I want to take you through this logically. And at the end, we will end up with the formulas derived, and you will have a really, really good intuitive sense of how these formulas work, which is really important because in other types of counting problems, you may not always be able to just directly jump into the formula. The easiest way to get started with a counting problem is with a picture. So each of these slots represents a potential card in my hand. When I draw the first card from the deck of 52, I have 52 possible options. So I'm going to put the number 52 in my first slot. Now, once I've taken one card out of the deck has 51 cards left. So for my second card, I only have 51 options left. So I'll put 51 here. Again, now I've pulled two cards, so for my third card, I only have 50 options left. I've pulled three cards, so I have 49 left, and 48. Now, whenever you're counting the different ways of doing things, you want to use the multiplication principle. So to figure out how many different permutations we have of these, I'm going to multiply all them together. Multiplying this out, I get 311,875,200. And no, I did not do that in my head. I definitely used a calculator for that calculation. Now, this is the number of permutations. Remember in our introduction, I told you that the difference between combinations and permutations is order. In permutations, the order matters, in combinations, it doesn't. So in the problem that we want to solve, order doesn't matter. It doesn't matter if I draw a 2 of hearts first or a 2 of hearts second, as long as a 2 of hearts is in my hand. This means that the arrangement, a 2 of hearts, 3 of hearts, 4 of hearts, 5 hearts, 6 hearts, is different than 3 of hearts, 2 of hearts, 4 of hearts, 5 of hearts, 6 of hearts, even though they are the same hand. So far we've succeeded at calculating the permutations. Now the question is, how do I get rid of those repeat hands? And to do that, I need to divide them out. This boils down to a subproblem here. Now I want to figure out how many different ways I can arrange 5 cards. And once I find out how many ways I can do that, I can divide out all those repeat hands from this large number. So again, I have 5 cards, so 5 slots. And I'm just working with one hand of 5 unique cards. and seeing how many arrangements I can make. So I have 5 options for the first card, 4 options for the second, 3, 2, 1, just like we did up here. And I'm gonna multiply these together to get 120. This means that any one hand of cards can be arranged 120 ways. Think about that for a second. That means when you're sitting there with your cards in your hand and you're trying to organize them, there are 120 different ways you could organize those cards. I want to get rid of all of those repeated arrangements. So I'm going to take our number, our total number of permutations, and divide it by 120, which is all the ways I could arrange any 5 cards. Alright, so we still have a really large number, but it's not nearly as large as the number of permutations. So the number of different combinations of 5 card hands from 52 card deck is 2,598,960. Now let's take a look at how this relates to the combinations formula. So here I have this number from multiplying 52 down to 48. And I divided it by this 5 down to 1. Now we're going to do a little bit of clever rewriting to get this into an alternate form. And to do this, we are going to use factorials. Now 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 is equivalent to 5 factorial. So I'm going to rewrite that. Now in the numerator, if I wanted to express this as 52 factorial, I would need to make sure I cancel out everything that's below 48. So that's exactly what we're going to do. I'm gonna write 52 factorial in the numerator, which gives me all the integers from 52 down to 1 being multiplied together. I only want the ones down to 48, so I'm going to divide out everything from 47 and down, which I can express as 47 factorial. All right, now what we have here is the definition of the combinations formula. So this can be rewritten as notations for the combinations formula, and you would read it as N choose K. So in some books, you might see it written as an N on top of a K inside of parentheses, or as a giant C with an N superscript and a K subscript, or as a giant C with a little N in front and a little K after, or as a C with an N and K in parentheses. But they all mean the same thing. They are all the choose or combinations formula, and the formula for them is N factorial over K factorial times N minus K factorial. And as you can see, that looks a lot like what we wrote up here. So this is the same as 52 choose 5. And when you say it out loud, it makes a lot of sense because I have 52 cards and I want to choose 5 of them. Plugging it into the formula, we would have 52 factorial over 5 factorial times 52 minus 5 factorial. We would subtract these to get 47 factorial. And then we could rewrite 52 factorial as 52 times 51. And because everything's multiplication, this 47 factorial would cancel out with this 47 factorial, leaving us with 52 times 51 times 50 times 49 times 48. All over 5 factorial. And that's really awesome because we have derived the combinations formula. Recall that the only difference between the combinations and the permutations that we had up here was that we divided out all the repeat pairs. So that means our permutations formula is just like the combinations formula, but without this number divided out. So what does that look like? So So the permutations formula, which can be written in a variety of notations as well, boils down to n factorial over n minus k factorial, which is just the same as our combinations formula without this k factorial, which removes out all the arrangements we don't care about when we're talking about combinations. To summarize, the difference between combinations and permutations is that in combinations, we don't care about the order of our items. That means that we are going to divide out all of the extra arrangements that are the same combination. And that's why we have this extra k factorial in the denominator. In permutations, we want all of the possible arrangements in every order. And so in this formula, we don't need to divide out the extra arrangements. As always, there are two really easy things you can do to show your support for Math Hacks and keep these tutorials coming. One, hit that subscribe button and join our community if you haven't already. And two, give this video a big thumbs up to let everyone know that you enjoyed it. Till next time, guys, I'm Brett Berry, and thank you for watching.